Subscribe to Simplified Biology channel and press the bell icon to get notified when a new video is uploaded. Hello friends, welcome to Simplified Biology. Today's topic is competition. Now, competition is an interaction between individuals of either same species or different species competing or struggling for the same resources. Competition may be intraspecific or interspecific. Intraspecific competition means interaction between individuals of same species. Now, this interaction or this competition is more acute as their requirements are same. And this could lead to reduction in the size of the population. While interspecific interaction or competition is interaction between different species having the same feeding habits. That is, they belong to the same trophic level. Now, usually plants and herbivores are more affected by competition than the carnivores. Example, in grassland ecosystem, competition is seen between the herbivores. They may be deer, rabbit, bison, zebra, and cow. Competition also occurs between totally unrelated species for the same resources. Like in the shallow lakes of South America, flamingos, they compete with the fishes for the same food, that is the zooplanktons found in the lake. The flamingos compete with the resident fishes for the zooplankton found in the lake. Carnivores like tiger and leopard compete for the same prey. In forest ecosystem, trees, shrubs, herbs, they compete for light, water, and minerals. When resources are unlimited or abundant, then too competition is seen. And that is interference competition. Means one species who is more efficient in feeding reduces the other species due to interference and its inhibitory presence. Or feeding efficiency of one species is reduced due to interference and inhibitory presence of the other species. But when the resources are limited, competitively superior species will eliminate the other species. When resources are limited, the superior species completely eliminates the other species. Like abandoned tortoise. Now this is the abandoned tortoise found in the Galapagos Island. It became extinct within 10 years. When goat were introduced into the island. Now, due to a greater browsing efficiency of the goat, the tortoise were completely extincted from the island. Next is competitive release. A species is restricted to a small geographical area due to presence of a competitively superior species. When the superior species is removed, there is a dramatically increase in population of the smaller species. This is known as competitive release. A superior species prevents the inferior one to a particular geographical area. It doesn't allow it to spread. Now, when the superior species is removed, the inferior one population increases to a great extent. The best example of which is Colonel's experiment in the rocky sea coast of Scotland. There are two types of barnacles, Balanus and Samalus. Balanus are the superior ones and the larger ones, while Samalus are the smaller and the inferior ones. Now the Balanus forced the Samalus to occupy a smaller and drier habitat. Now these are the Samalus which occupy smaller and drier habitat, as the Balanus dominates the intertidal zone and eliminates them from this region. Samalus are able to live both in the dried and the shallow intertidal zone. Now when the Balanus are removed, there is a drastic increase in the population of the Samalus. This is the best example of competitive release. Gauss competitive exclusion principle. Now, according to this principle, or this principle states that two closely related species that are competing for the same resource cannot coexist indefinitely, and the inferior one will be eliminated eventually. Two species that are competing for the same resource cannot remain together indefinitely. One will get extincted. This is Gauss' competitive exclusion principle. Now, the experiment done by Gauss was by taking two species of Paramecium, Paramecium aurelia and Paramecium caudatum, both of which compete for the same food. Now, when these two species are grown separately, they grow very well, as you can see in this graph. But when they are both grown together, the Aurelia species thrives better than the caudatum. Means the Aurelia species dominates and it drives the caudatum species to extinction. So, basing on this, the Gauss competitive exclusion principle was given. Now, Gauss competitive exclusion principle is true only when the resources are limited. Recent studies do not support this principle. Species that are facing competition might evolve mechanisms so that they can coexist. Like, to avoid competition, they can choose different time for the feeding, or different feeding patterns or foraging patterns. This is known as resource partitioning. MacArthur's example on resource partitioning was the five closely related warblers which lived on the same tree. They were able to live on the same tree, avoiding competition. This was due to their behavioral differences, and differences in their foraging activities. That is, food eating or hunting activities. activities. Now, these are the five warblers which coexisted, avoiding competition on the same tree by feeding on different parts of the tree and eating different types of insects. That's all for today. Please do like, subscribe, and comment, and also visit our website by clicking on the link given below. Thank you. Thank you for watching.